Hello, welcome to the second session of the lecture on VetBACT. Today I will demonstrate how VetBACT can be used and how you can utilize the different functionalities in VetBACT to get information about bacteria that are of interest in veterinary medicine. Here we have the start page of VetBACT, and you can immediately see here that we can change the language between Swedish and English, but this lecture is in English, so let's stick to the English part of VetBACT here. And I will first start to discuss the upper list here, which contains different links. The first link here to the blog will be discussed during the next session, so we skip that for today. And then we have biochemical tests, and if you click on that link, you will get the list of different biochemical tests that are used to identify bacteria. Let's choose the coagulase test here as an example. I click on that and we get information about the test. First, some general information about the coagulase test, then information about how the method is performed and how a positive and a negative reaction may look. You can also see that on the picture here. And also you have a heading use, where you can find information about when this test is used. So let's go back to the start page again. And take the next link here, growth media. Here you find information about growth media for different kind of bacteria or for different purposes in identification. And we can choose one of the media here, for instance, the dip slide, which is used for urine samples. You have an introduction to the test here, and how the dip slides is used for urine samples, and pictures of the slides which has not yet been incubated. So let's go back to the start page again, and we can take the next link, terms. This link contains different terms which are used in bacteriology. All these terms are explained, and it's far from complete, but we are working on improving it all the time. And we can have a look on, for instance, anaerobic bacteria here, so you can see what you may find. First, we have an introduction to what anaerobic bacteria means and about the different kind of metabolism you can find in this connection. Then you have information about how oxygen can be toxic for a cell and how the bacteria can detoxify the poisonous compounds which are formed in the presence of oxygen. You have images here which illustrates the information on this page, and we can enlarge this image so you can see a little better. So here you find information about the different enzymes that bacteria have to be able to detoxify these compounds. So let's go back here to the start page again. And then I want to discuss the other links here. We have, for instance, images where you can see thumbnail pictures of all the images that we have in VetBACT. And here you can also get an impression and see that it is rather many. You can sort these images. Here they are sorted after type of image, but if we want, we can sort them in alphabetic order instead. And here we have them in alphabetic order. And let's choose some of the one of the picture here. For instance, the Nicoletella Semolina picture here. This is a picture which illustrates how the colonies of this bacterium can be moved onto the agar plate by means of a plastic loop, something which may be useful in identification of this bacterium. And if you go to the bacterial page of this bacterium, you will also find this image, but we will do that a little later. So let's also look on the other links here. Publications, we have a few publications here which are included in a list which you can go to and read yourself. You can also go to this link about VetBact, where you can read more about the website and the database. Here you have a contact form, which you also can find, in fact, on all pages in VetBact. But if you want to contact us, you can use this contact form where you can write down the subject and a message. And if you want to have a reply, you have to write down at least your email address also, and preferably also your name. And then you submit it, and we will read and give a reply to you later. We turn to the start page again, and then I will say a few words about these headings here: recently updated, recently described, recent name change, and most frequently visited. First, recently updated. Here you have a list of bacteria which we have recently updated the information about, and not only bacteria but also terms and biochemical test or growth media, for instance. Here you can see that we recently updated the information about the anaerobic bacteria. That you can try yourself and see what we have done. Recently described, these are bacteria of importance in veterinary medicine which has been described during the last years. Sometimes it happens in bacteriology that bacterial names are changed, and that could cause confusion, particularly for practicing veterinarians who doesn't keep perhaps updated in bacteriology. So here you have a list of the new names, and you can go to the corresponding pages. But remember, you can always find the old names of these bacteria also in VetBact. So by making a search here on the old name, you can find the same bacterium as you find here by using the new name of it. Then we have a list of the most frequently visited bacteria, and here you see three of them. And if you want to see more, you can click here and you can get a list of the bacteria and the number of visits we have had on that page during the last 7 days. You can see here that Staphylococcus epidermidis is in top. It has been for a rather long time now. Maybe it will change in future, I don't know. But sometimes we can see that if there is an outbreak of a bacterial infectious disease somewhere, often the number of visits increase here. Then I should say something also about another heading which you find down here, course material. That will be discussed also during the next session and during the last session, so that we skip for today. But we can try the quick search here. So here you can write down a name of a bacterium. Let's choose, for instance, Escherichia coli, and you write it down here. And suppose we make a mistake in the spelling. We can write something like that and don't make it even complete, just the first part of the name, and do a search. Yeah, so you see here we have search on Escherich, which we have done a mistake in the spelling. So then the program suggests that we should search on only this part of the word which is correctly spelled, or at least that there is something in the database. So if we do that, you can just click here and you see we get Escherichia coli, and we also get some other pages because Escherichia coli is named is mentioned on these pages. And among the terms or the growth media, you can also find Escherichia coli, but probably you are interested in the bacterial page, which you can come to if you click here. But we will do that a little later. First, we go back to the start page again. And now we have to look at something which is important here, the so-called phylogeny list. All bacteria are divided into approximately 25 major lines of descent. And these major lines of descent are called phyla. And all phyla are not of importance in veterinary medicine, but if you click on phylum here, you get the list of the 9 bacterial phyla that are of importance in veterinary medicine. And if you go down in the phylogenetic hierarchy, you come to class. And here, of course, you have more classes than you have phyla. And you can go to order and get the orders which you find representatives for in that pact. You can go to family, you can go to genus, and you can even continue to species and subspecies. And then you get a list of all bacteria which we have information about in that pact. And you get some other information here also. You see that here we have also introduced a list of bacterial names in Chinese, because there is a great interest in China for using VetBact, but they have problems with the bacterial names because they are quite different in Chinese. So therefore we have included this list of bacterial names. All bacterial names are here in Chinese in this list. And if you click here on the corresponding bacteria, you come to that bacterium in the database. But this is probably something which you who listen to this will not use. Then you can also get the system to show only the most important species. And you can see here that we have color codes for the bacteria. So bacteria which have a red color code, they are very important in veterinary medicine. Bacteria which have yellow color are also important, but a little less important than those which are very important. And if you go down here, you can see also green bacteria. And green bacteria are of very small importance in veterinary medicine. And finally, those which are blue are bacteria which are of primarily are of importance in human medicine. So if you want to the system to show only the most important bacteria, you click here. And here you can also see the genome size of the bacteria. For instance, if you click on here, you sort the bacteria according to genome size. And Burkholderia pseudomallei is the one which has the largest genome of those bacteria which are listed in VetBact. You can find accession number to 16S rRNA sequences in GenBank, and you can see how many operons, ribosomal RNA operons, the bacteria have by clicking here. And here you can see that members of genus Bacillus, Clostridium, Vibrio are examples of bacteria which have rather many ribosomal RNA operons. And finally, you can get a list and sort the bacteria after the date we have updated them. So if you click here, you can see the bacteria which were very recently updated. So let's go back here to the phylogeny list and click on class here. We have again the different classes, but instead of continuing in this list, we can continue in the list down here. So we can choose one class here, gamma proteobacteria for instance, and click on that and see what happens. Then you can see here that we came from the class gamma proteobacteria, and we get a list of the orders which are included among the gamma proteobacteria. Where we have, for instance, the Enterobacteriales, the order which are found in the gut of animals or even humans. And if you click on that, you get one family, Enterobacteriaceae. And if you click on that, you can see the different genera which we have in Jetbacked. And if you choose on one of them, Klebsiella for instance, you get a list of a species of the species within this genus, where you can click on one of them and you get information on the corresponding bacterial page. We'll return to that in just a few seconds. But let's first go to the start page again. And if you are interested in a certain bacterium and know what genus it belongs to, and if you know the name of it, you know of course the genus, because that's the first part of the name. So you can click on genus here. And then you can select a genus, for instance Escherichia coli. It's a very common bacterium which is important both in human and veterinary medicine, and it is also belongs also to the normal flora of the gut. So I click on that and I get the species here which I can click on, because there is only one species within Escherichia in Vetbacked. And here we have the bacterial page. And here we can first have a look on the different headings you see here to the left. Species or subspecies, that is of course understandable as it is. But the other headings, for instance, etymology, if you don't know what that is, you can click on the heading here and you get information about it. And that you can do for all headings to the left here. We called it field headings because it's headings for the fields you find here. And then you can see that we also have pictures here. Let's remove that pop-up window. We have pictures here, thumbnail pictures under macromorphology. And here you can find, for instance, pictures on the E. coli on blood agar. Here you see the overview of the plate with a scale included here also. And here you can read more about the culturing conditions. And here you see an enlargement of a certain part of this image to the left, where you can see the morphology of the colonies. If you want to look on some other pictures, we can remove that. Gram staining is of course important in diagnostic bacteriology. If we click on this image, you can see how the bacteria appear in the microscope after gram staining. Here you easily see that it is a gram negative bacterium, E. coli. And if you will try to see the morphology of the cells a little better, you can look on this enlarged part, where you can easily see that this bacterium forms so-called rods. So then we can remove this image also. And then you have different kind of information about morphology, about how it appears in gram staining, about the metabolism. And we have to scroll down here a little, so you can see that you have information about which carbohydrate E. coli can ferment, about microbiological tests, for instance, the motility test is written about. It's common to use that to confirm E. coli. And here you can have an image about how the result of a motility test can look. There are more information here which can be useful for you, and that is of course the disease. It's a little complicated in the case of E. coli, because there are many different pathotypes of E. coli which cause different diseases in different animals. We have also the name both in Swedish and in English, as you can see here. Sometimes there are information about the clinical picture, but we haven't included information about that yet, because it's very complicated with E. coli because of all these pathotypes. But here you have a list of different virulence factors of different pathotypes also. There is information about if the genome has been sequenced and how you can find that sequence, and also about the ribosomal RNA sequence. If E. coli is mentioned in some kind of official papers, some legislations of some kind, you can find information about that here. And sometimes there are also some comments which are relevant. And finally, you have references here. So if you click on that, you get a pop-up window with a number of references. We try to refer to theses if it is possible to find that for a certain bacterium. I go down here. I think we are ready with E. coli here. But let's go to another bacterium here. We can go to one which I have recently updated here, Campylobacter jejuni, subspecies jejuni, because there we have something which we don't have on all other bacterial pages. For instance, electron micrographs, scanning beam electron micrographs, where you can see the very typical shape of Campylobacter. It's called gull-winged shape. We have something else which I also want to show you. If we scroll down here, you have information about taxonomy or phylogeny here, and we can also get a phylogenetic tree where we have Campylobacter jejuni, subspecies jejuni here at the blue arrow, and all bacteria which are written in blue here are included in VetBact, and other bacteria are also included in order to see the relation between the different bacteria, and you can see here which families the bacteria contain belongs to. So I think I have gone through VetBact now, and time for you to try this on your own. And I wish you good luck until the next time we see each other. That will be during the third session of VetBact. See you later.